past 24 hours, David, President Trump has taken two key actions to further chip away at President Obama's legacy, killing Obamacare subsidies, decertifying the Iran deal. Do you see some strategies here, or is this all about blowing up the former president's legacy?
I think that it's more about blowing up the president, former president's legacy than anybody wants to admit. Anything which has the name Obama on it, it by automatically becomes, you know, a target for Donald Trump. And he's trying to reverse as much of that as possible. What's worrisome about this, Don, is that what this means is that the poisonous relationship that now exists on domestic policy issues is creeping into foreign policy as well. Mm-hmm. And that is that one president can make a deal and the next president, because the former he doesn't like the former president, different party, he's the enemy, therefore we have to cancel the deal. And that obviously winds into this Iran situation, but it also winds into the Obamacare. You know, one of the reasons he looks like he's sabotaging or laying the groundwork for sabotaging the Iran deal. In the same way, he looks like he's trying to sabotage Obamacare. Yeah. It has the former president's name on it, former party. He wants to appeal to his base. Everybody, the country overwhelmingly in polls said, we don't want to repeal with no replacement. I mean, because it leaves a lot of people to suffer in insurance markets that become chaotic. And why we would do this when the country itself is so opposed to it suggests it's the president's internal urge. And what we did in Iran was to scratch his itch. You know, we didn't need to go this route on this, but his aide said, let's find something that's going to keep the president, you know, feeling somewhat satisfied. We're doing the same thing in Obamacare. And that is, I've never seen a situation where, because a president has an impulse, because a president has a dislike, that policy is suddenly bent to sort of satisfy some psychic inner need of the president.
Yeah, Bob, you smiled when I asked if it was about blowing up Obama's legacy. And I think it's, you know, he says it looks like, I think it's fairly obvious. I
mean, it is. Yeah. And as you said earlier in the show, is that this is what Trump ran on. And you look at his biggest promises, getting rid of Obamacare, hasn't happened yet. His number one promise, build the wall, hasn't happened. So I think there's that Trump is thinking, I got to do something. I got to get rid of this guy.
He's obsessed.
Right.
Yeah.
And without a doubt, I mean, was there anything that Trump ever praised Obama for? I can't remember. Any program that he liked? No.
No, especially the actions today with Obamacare and with Iran just seems like, you know, I've got to do this because I want to, you know, I've got, because it is the former president and I'm not getting anything done.
And I can't get Congress to do it, so I'm going to do it myself.
So I'm going to do it myself. Margaret, weigh in on this. Is the base happy about this?
Well, I think there are really two different issues to look at. And I think the president has signaled very clearly in terms of health care that he not only is willing to, but wants to blow the whole thing up. I think on Iran, it's a little bit less clear, and some of his aides, maybe they're just fooling themselves, but continue to hold out hope that this, at least for the next 2 months and perhaps longer, will keep that deal alive long enough for European allies to convince the president not to blow it up, for Congress, congressional Republicans to convince the president not to walk away from the deal, etc. When it comes to health care, though, for now, and you saw the president talking at the Value Voter Summit. Some of the moves on healthcare have involved taking away coverage of, birth control and that sort of thing. That absolutely is red meat for the base. One of the longer term questions is how some of those members of his base will feel when they themselves lose health benefits as a result of some of these changes. And
those are the people who are most at risk of losing it is the Trump voter. But go on.
I was going to say, certainly in terms of two things. Number one, this move toward the associations and the shorter term medical coverage, which he announced yesterday. And then the subsequent move today, last night and today, that looks at removing those subsidies. That's going to have an effect on millions of people. And many of those millions of people are Trump supporters. And the question politically is, will they blame him or will they blame Barack Obama? The question substantively is, what's going to happen to coverage for those Americans?
Well, he certainly will blame Barack Obama. And it's interesting because he has fooled his base into saying that it is fake news, that the exchanges or Obamacare is collapsing, into believing it. And then when they start losing health care, he's going to say, well, you're losing your health care because of Obamacare, because of the former president. David, if Congress doesn't act on this Iran deal, excuse me, Jim Sciutto, if Congress doesn't act on this Iran deal, Democrats don't come to the table on health care, is it on Trump or Congress? Is the President Trump attempting to skirt any of the blame of a failure here?
Well, if you listen to the president's words today, he said that if Congress doesn't act to improve the deal to his satisfaction, he will cancel the deal. Now, whether the president follows through on that after 60 days, we don't know, or whether he could punt again, we don't know. But he did lay out the possibility of walking away from this deal. And just to your larger point, Don, about, and to David's point as well, about the intention behind this, you know, this Iran decision, it's a decision looking for a rationale, really, right? Because, you know, the certification process was imposed by Congress on this deal to make sure, in effect, that Iran doesn't cheat on the deal, to give Congress an opportunity and the president an opportunity as the deal was functioning, that if Iran doesn't fulfill its part of the bargain, to pull away from it. Now, the fact is, Iran is fulfilling its side of the bargain. Don't listen to me. Listen to all of Trump's senior advisors, his defense secretary, his heads of the intelligence agencies, his secretary of state. They, and listen to the allies who signed the agreement. Iran is in compliance. The IAEA, which oversees the agreement, said the same today. So there's no actual rationale here for the president to decertify, but he's using the language of that congressional oversight to kind of find a way out. Again, yeah. It's a decision looking for a rationale. He's found that rationale, but it certainly doesn't match the outlines of the agreement as negotiated by the U.S. and its partners.
The rationale rhymes with Obama. That's all you need. Thank you all. Thank you, Jim. Thank you, Bob, David, and Margaret. I appreciate it. When we come back, what's the reaction around the world to President Trump's threat to kill the Iran deal? Will anybody trust us at the negotiating table?